Hey guys, Mrs. Dan's here. So today we're going to skip to lesson five because it's about graphing and we've done so much graphing that I thought it would be a good lesson to do on a Monday, a day that everyone's all virtual. So I will teach you very thoroughly. You can, of course, attend office hours to ask any questions that you have. And I did provide you with the answers to lesson two in your Google Classroom. So if any of those questions gave you trouble, please make sure you attend the office hours and ask. So copy down the objective for lesson five. Make sure you go to lesson five. Of course, you should hit pause anytime you feel like I'm moving a little too fast. And after you get the objective down, I'd like you to do the do now without watching me do it. So if you could hit pause and do it, and then I'll turn the video back on, that would be great. So what we could see that they're asking us about in the do now is about inequalities. The number one is talking about the line that's graphed in blue with the blue shading. Right, you could see that it's crossing the y-axis at 5, and you can see it has a slope of negative 3. Looks like it went down 3 over 1. And it's a dashed line because it's not equal to. And since it says y is greater than, you shade up. So that's how come that line was shaded that way. Name a point that's in the solution set. Oh my goodness, there's so many of them, right? I could pick this point, which is 3, 4. I could pick this point, which is 5, 5. I could pick this point, which is 6, -1. So there's not just one right answer. Anything in that shaded region for that blue shaded region is in the solution set. Then on number two, they're talking about the pink line. Guess I'll just pick red. And you can see that the y-intercept is at negative 2. You could see that the slope is up 1 over 1. You can see that it's a solid line because it's also equal to. And since it says y is less than or equal to, they shaded down. Then it asks for a point in the solution set. And again, there's an infinite number of answers. Anything in that red shaded region, so the point 1, -4, the point 2, -2, even over here is in the red region, 6, -4. Anything in that red shaded region is a solution to that second inequality. Then on number three, very important, they're asking to name a point that's in the solution to both. Now you could see when I shaded it myself, I used the lines, the way that I taught you to shade, and you could see that crisscrossing of shading, which actually, when the computer shades it, a blue and a red turns it into a purplish looking color. So anything in that purple area or anything in that crisscross area where both the red and the blue shading are, that's a solution to both inequalities. So there's still an infinite number of answers, but it has to be something in this crisscross shaded region. So 4, 0, 5, 0, 5, -1, 6, -3, 6, 2, right? There's still an infinite number of solutions, but it has to be in that section where both the red and the blue shading intersect. And that's really the whole entire lesson. As long as you know how to graph a single inequality on a set of axes, then you can graph a system of inequalities. So a system, again, means more than one, because we've done systems of equations. So now we're going to be graphing more than one inequality on a single set of axes, and where the shadings intersect is a point that's in the solution set to the system of inequalities. So we'll do some classwork together, and then if we just like look ahead for a moment, your homework is from the textbook, page 384 to 385. Number 10, 20, 23, 40, and 42. Your assignment for today is to turn in the classwork and the homework. So they ask us to solve each system by graphing. The only way to graph is to get into y equals mx plus b form. So I will take the first equation. I'm actually going to keep on doing this red and blue color. So I'll do the first one in blue. So 3x plus y is greater than or equal to negative 4. I have to get y by itself. So I'll subtract 3x from both sides. And I get y is greater than or equal to negative 3x minus 4. The slope is negative 3. The y-intercept is negative 4. So I will start at the negative 4. And a slope of negative 3 means go down 3 to the right 1. Or I could go in the complete opposite direction. Since it's also equal to, it's a solid line. When solved for y, it says y is greater than, so that's the up part of the line. Again, if you have a hard time deciding what's up and what's down, pick a test point. I like to pick the point 0, 0. If I test 0, 0 in the original equation, I would have 0 plus 0 greater than or equal to 4 is 0, I mean negative 4. Is 0 greater than or equal to negative 4? That's true. So the point 0, 0 has to get shaded over. And you can see on my graph, the point 0, 0 is shaded over. I need to label this line. Now I will graph the other one. I will change to red. I have to get it into y equals mx plus b form. So I'll subtract 3x from both sides. So y is less than or equal to negative 3x plus 3. The y-intercept is at 3. The slope is negative 3, so I'll go down 3 to the right 1. And you could see that these inequalities, their lines have the same slope. But since it's an inequality with shading, it's still possible to have a solution. I did draw a solid line because it was also equal to. And when it's solved for y, you see it says y is less than or equal to. So now I shade down. So these shadings do intersect in between those two lines. What we like to do, I'm going to pick black and make it even thicker. We actually like to label the solution set with a big S to stand for solution. If I went back to the do now, I could put a big S in that double shaded region. So we do like to label the solution set with a large letter S to indicate where the solution is, because sometimes it's a little confusing to the eye to look for that double shaded region. So we want to clearly label it. If you had a highlighter, you could actually highlight the double shaded region to make it stand out. Having a hard time highlighting. Well. This won't highlight for some reason. Anyway, I label it with a big letter S. It asks us to name a point in the solution set. So you need to pick any point that's in that double shaded region. Definitely the point 0, 0 is in that double shaded region. There's a lot of points though. I could see like the point 1, negative 4. Is in that double shaded region. Anything in that double shaded region is a solution to the system. Number 2, Again, we have to get it into y equals mx plus b form. Just gonna. I will use blue for my first line. I'm going to do the work over here. I'll subtract x from both sides first. I do not want a negative y. Remember, that's like a negative 1y. So I have to divide both sides by negative 1. Don't forget, when you divide by a negative, the inequality turns around. And also be careful of your signs here. A negative 1x divided by negative 1 is now a positive 1x. And a positive 1 divided by a negative 1 is now a minus 1 or a negative 1. So my slope is 1 and my y-intercept is negative 1. So I'll start at negative 1 and go up 1, right 1. This will be a dashed line because it doesn't equal it. Oh, it says y is less than, so I'll shade down. If you picked a test point and tested it in the original equation, it would say that 0 is greater than 1, and you could see that the point 0, 0, if I tested the point 0, 0, that is, sorry, you could see that the point 0, 0, would not get shaded over because 0 is not greater than 1. I have to label this. And I have to graph the next line. Now the next line just says that x is less than or equal to negative 1. Remember, x equals a number is a vertical line. So it's a vertical line going through the x-axis at negative 1, and it's solid because it also equals it. And use your common sense. It says x is less than negative 1. Where are the x's that are less than negative 1? Oh, they're this way. Let's label this line also. And now they ask, is the point negative 1, negative 2 a solution to the system? So let's look at where negative 1, negative 2 is. It's right here. It's right where those lines intersect. But guess what? It's not a solution. Remember, the solution to a system of equations is where the two lines intersect. A solution to the system of inequalities, it's not where the two lines intersect, but it's where the two shadings overlap. Definitely, this point is not a solution because it's on a dashed line. Remember, a dashed line is just like a placeholder. Any point on that dashed line is not a solution to that inequality. So this point, negative 1, negative 2, is not a solution to the system. It is not in the shaded region. We could also say that any point on a dashed line is not a solution. So let's move on. Remember, hit pause anytime you need to. Oh, I want to label this the solution set. And I think I forgot to label this line up here. Let me do that too. Right, time to move on. So number three, it is a solution of inequalities. Now instead of just having two inequalities, we have three. I'm glad that they're all like solve for y. It makes it go much quicker. I could see that the first one, the slope is 1 and the y-intercept's 4. I will use blue. I'll start at 4 and I'll go up one right one. I can see it's also equal to, so it will be a solid line. And this is y is less than, so I'm going to shade down. I'm going to label this before I move on. And now I'll graph the next one in red. Be careful of the order here, right? This is really like a negative x plus 4, which means that my y-intercept is 4 again, but my slope is now a negative 1. It's also equal to, so it'll be a solid line. It says y is less than, so I shade down. I will label the line before I go on. And I will graph the last one in green. Says that y is less than 0. So remember, whenever it says y equals some number, it's a horizontal line. It's a horizontal line crossing the y-axis at 0. Oh, it should be dashed. Happens to be right on the x-axis. It says that y is less than 0. The y is less than 0 or down here. I'm going to see if my highlighter works in maybe a different color. There's a strange shape where the three overlappings occur. Yep, my highlighter does not work. So I'm going to use my black pen and put a big S down in this area. I want to point out that it follows this blue line and this dashed line and this red line. Anything down there is where the red, the blue, and the green shading are. If I had a highlighter that worked, I would definitely highlight this. Name a point in the solution set, like this point, which is at 0, negative 3. And there's a lot of them down there. Just be really careful. Next, now they're asking us to write our own system. So I will do that solid line first. I could see that the y-intercept is at 6, and I can see it's going down one right one. So I'm thinking about y equals, but it's really not equal to, it's got to be an inequality. 1x plus 6. What inequality do I put there, though? Look at that little bit of shading that they did. What they do sometimes is all they do is shade where the overlap occurs. So this line must have been being shaded up in order for that little region to start getting shaded. So this is a greater than or equal to. And then the other line that's dashed, that's a horizontal line. So that's just a y in the equation. It's crossing the y-axis at 1. It's not equal to, and do you notice that that little shaded area is below that line? Which means this whole line must have been shaded downward. And now you could see that the overlap is right in that little shaded region that they did. So sometimes, like, a problem that's already graphed for you, sometimes to make it clear to the reader's eye, they just shade the overlapped region. If they ask you to write your own inequality, you have to decide which line got shaded up, which line got shaded down. So this line that I did in red is shaded down, therefore this is a less than. So that is the system of inequalities that's represented in this graph. Number five, could you make a system of inequalities with no solutions? So I had spoken about this problem here, number one, where these parallel lines actually have a solution because the shaded regions went towards each other. Therefore, the overlap happened between the two parallel lines. If this was a system of equations and there wasn't any shading involved, there'd be no solution, right? A system of equations is where the two lines intersect and parallel lines don't intersect anywhere. But since this was an inequality, I was looking at the shaded regions and I did make the shaded regions overlap each other. So is it possible then to have a system of inequalities with no solutions? And the answer is yes, right? Imagine if I had two parallel lines, but what if they shaded away from each other? Then those shaded regions would never overlap each other. Therefore, they would not be a solution. So yes, if you had parallel lines with the shading going away from each other. Number six, the graph of an inequality is shown below. It's actually shown to the right. Write the inequality represented by the graph. So I want to see the y-intercept. There's no scale on this graph. Anytime a scale is not written, we assume that the scale on both the x and the y-axis is going by ones. So I would say that the y-intercept is at negative 3. And I could see that it's going up to the right one. So the slope is 2/1. So y shading is going up is greater than, it's a solid line, so it's greater than or equal to 2x minus 3. Now it's asking us on the same set of axes to graph that given inequality. So I'll change to blue. I will solve for y first. So I get that y is less than negative 1/2 x plus 2. Remember, this negative in front of the x is really a negative 1. So the y-intercept's at 2. The slope is negative 1/2. That means go down one right 2. You could go in the other direction. It is going to be a dashed line. Y is less than, so I shade down. Now that I have more than one inequality on a set of axes, I really do have to label these. And now I can answer part C. The two inequalities graphed on the same set of axes form a system. True. Oscar thinks that the point 2, 1, I'm gonna change to black, 2-1 is in the solution set for this system of inequalities. Determine and state whether you agree with Oscar. Explain your reasoning. Well, we did a question like this already. Do you remember? It was this one right here. Is the point negative 1, negative 2 a solution to the system? So this is the same problem. It's a common mistake. So that's why Oscar thinks it's a solution, but he's wrong, right? The solution to a system of inequalities is where the shading overlaps and it can never be on a dashed line. I have to tell you, if these are both solid lines, then that would be a solution. And anything over here would be a solution also. So a solution, picking the intersection of two lines for a solution to inequalities is acceptable if both lines are solid. But Oscar's wrong because it's on a dashed line. And there we go. I hope that was helpful. Use these notes to help you get through your homework. And again, ask any questions during office hours. I will give you the answers to this homework tomorrow. And tomorrow we will be doing lesson 3. So have a good day, and I'll talk to you soon. Bye.